She look good? If I turn around and she's sticking her tongue out at me, that's... Fantastic. Oh my God. You look great.
You look fabulous.
I clean up all right.
You're ridiculous. I like the flowers. They did a good job pinning them.
There are so many pins in danger of slitting my throat. It's weird. Yeah. Nick and Phil got that on.
No,
it took,
doesn't.
It took both of them to get these boutonnieres on me.
It took two people to get me into the dress.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because
I can't complain. Yeah.
I couldn't get... They're like, squeeze! And I was like, I don't have enough!
What's you that? Look fantastic. Oh, that's absolutely brilliant.
Feel the lace. It's really soft. Ooh. I know, right?
I can see why you chose this dress.
Whoa.
You are kick-ass. Yeah, right?
I thought you went with the skulls.
Phil did, so we couldn't both wear the same liner. One of us would have to go home and change. Oh, nice. Right back at you. Yeah.
Do you like the nails?
Are these the cat?
Yeah.
They look better than they do in the box.
I know, right? We had Freya with us after all. And I'm basically an orange cat. You weren't supposed to agree.
Oh my God.
This looks great.
Yeah, right? The vest? Yeah, Morgan looks good in his too.
I am not shocked,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, he looks really good. Pocket square. I was like, checkered pocket square? Are you sure? I feel like if I wear this, then I have something that makes the bow tie spin and my boutonniere might squirt water.
It doesn't
and Phil,
spin.
Yeah. Well, Phil was like, that's kind of you, isn't it? And I'm like, okay, good point.
We have matching glasses. Mine are a little bit oval, but...
Mine are rim hack. Yours look new.
You look great. I love it.
Today is September 3rd, 2022. And before we begin, I have one announcement from the bride and the groom. So, Kris and Morgan humbly remind everyone to please remain seated and keep their phones and attached cameras inside the ride at all times. They have hired a photographer and a videographer to capture how this moment looks and feels with their camera, so you can capture how it feels with your hearts.
Aww.
Okay. Aww. There we go. Thank you. So we do know that everybody has their cameras out right now. So we are going to take a moment. We're going to let everybody get a photo of this moment. You can pretend like, you know, we're doing something important. So everybody, get your phones out. Please do something, you know, get it out of your system. Okay. Everybody, everybody look that way. All right, you too. Get it done. Ready, Sophie?
You gotta get it both sides.
Yeah, selfie. Selfie time. That's true. All right. Does everybody have their phones out still? Okay, good. Turn them off. Everybody that you need to talk to is already within earshot. Also, Morgan is easily spooked, and Kris is easily distracted. So keep them out. Okay, but I'll do, please, you know, silence your phones or put them in airplane mode at this time, please. Good evening, fellow travelers. I welcome you on behalf of Kris and Morgan. We have brought ourselves to this space and this time. We have traveled here to be witnesses to Morgan and Kris as they take the first steps on what will be their epic journey together. And I say they are epic journeys because they are epic journeys. Kris, Morgan, think of the vast length of time between your first breaths, from learning how to walk, to the challenges you have faced, to the lessons you have learned, to this moment, here, standing before each other today. I ask everyone to think of your first breath, to think of all the way through your life to taking your seat here at this moment. Definitely feels a little longer considering the last 2 to 3 years, but we made it. Two people, each on their own epic journey, happen to cross paths, and after a while, make the decision to walk alongside each other. That's you two. Okay. Then they decide to combine their epic journeys into an even more epic team-up journey, probably for the group XP. So a few years ago, Morgan and Kris decided to be with one another, to forge together a better road than the ones that they walked alone. Today, we are united and gathered here for a single purpose, to witness the beginning of Kris and Morgan's new journey, their first steps together as a party of two, or rather four, considering Grimm and Freya.
Yes.
Okay. It's our cats.
They had to be in the ceremony. Today, we celebrate them as they start a new module of their adventure and take their first steps on what is now their journey together. For Kris, his journey started off in a far-off land known as Azeroth. No, wait, Maine. Okay. There, he met strangers in an internet video game who became his friends. Those same friends here today invited him to move to Washington, D.C. for a couple of weeks. How many years later now?
15
years later. Those friends did not steal his organs and sell them on the internet, but instead became an extended family. Morgan, when faced with a choice between London and D.C., Morgan's choice was simple. As a birthday present to her father, Bert, she chose D.C. There, in the dark forest of the capital, she found a kindred spirit, or perhaps a kind witch, who offered to introduce her to someone at a Halloween party, to which she said, "Fine." And then, to her surprise, she asked him out. He was the right kind of weird, her kind of weird, and just plain kind. Whether met on the internet or met in person, the course of their lives were changed by the way they chose kindness, that they valued treating other human beings with respect and with dignity. The rest happened naturally. Let us all strive to live by their example and consistently choose kindness. I now ask Kris and Morgan to declare their intent for one another. Do you, Morgan, take Kris to be your lawfully wedded person?
I do.
Do you, Kris, take Morgan to be your lawfully wedded person?
I do.
Great. I ask you both, on behalf of the ministry that I represent, will you have each other in marriage?
Yes.
We will.
Okay. I ask you a final time, in front of your friends and family, here and now, from this point on, will you have each other in marriage?
Yes.
It is done.
I think we're good.
Mm-hmm. Three times I have asked, and three times you have answered. From this point on, the trajectory of your lives will be irrevocably changed. It will be unlike anything you have ever experienced before. You should probably take a short rest and maybe contemplate this just for a short moment.
Yeah,
or you could just get married.
Yeah
let's do that. Yeah, let's do that. Morgan, we shall begin the hand fasting. So, hand fasting is a symbol of strength, of love, of commitment and devotion. It signifies a willingness and desire to grow alongside one another, to face each new day as a team. Drawing on individual strengths while learning to accept each other's help and support, it communicates the belief that together you will meet challenges you could never meet alone. Kris and Morgan, you have taken this time to learn about each other, to let your love grow stronger naturally and patiently, and to invest in one another fully. You shared laughter and excitement, were tested in the crucible, and have emerged victorious. Morgan and Kris, you have both come here to become bound to one another, to pledge to yourselves and to your family and friends that you will continue to love and support one another, growing stronger together each day. Is this true?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Good, I mean, that's why we're here.
Yeah.
So,
yes.
Okay, good. Yeah. So Kris, will you share what you have prepared for Morgan? Excellent.
Yep.
So, yeah, there you go. There you go. Yeah.
Public speaking, my favorite.
Yeah, there you go.
Not yet. You're supposed to keep my arm in your hand.
Right. Mm-hmm. I can't hold it too.
I'm holding it for you.
We've been trying to reach you about your cars. No, Phil, this doesn't look right.
No, hold on. Wait. It's just there.
Oh, okay. Okay.
There, right. Go.
I promise to always try to listen when you have something to say. Except for historical rants, I'll nod and smile as appropriate. I promise to take care of you when you're not feeling well. When you are sad, I will always try to make you laugh. Especially when it's not appropriate. I promise that every cold will, in fact, be terminal. I'm dying. There's no argument. I promise that no matter how much I grumble and complain, I will still try to fix something around the house before calling a qualified professional, begrudgingly. I promise that I will always try to make amends for any wrongs. I will always work on us together with you.
Aww.
Told myself I wouldn't cry. Anyway.
No ugly crying.
I promise to roll my eyes at every pun you make, even though you know I love them. I also promise that I love you, and by association, the cats, and I want to spend the rest of our lives together. I promise I'm never going to give you up.
I promise I'll never let you down.
I promise I will never run around or hurt you.
I will never make you cry.
I will never say goodbye. Or tell a lie.
Hurt you.
Okay.
It's our song.
Morgan, will you share what you've prepared for Kris?
Sure, I guess.
Yeah.
Why not? I promise to communicate with you, appreciate you in ways that you feel appreciated, and work with you together on chores, because I'm not your mom. She's over there. I promise to let you in on my medical discussions, treatments, while forcing you to go to the doctor at the same time. I promise to get your opinions on everything, even the small decisions like whether or not I should eat this block of cheese.
The answer is yes.
Right? I promise to always yell tall person activate when I can't reach something. I promise to run all the way back to base in video games, especially when you need my backup. I will be by your side as long as you want and are willing to be my partner in all things, but video games, apparently. And you must provide me with at least two cats our entire marriage. Partnership, life.
Yeah.
I'm taking cats in.
All Please join me in wishing these two the best on their new commitment to each other and to their new life together as we perform the hand fasting.
And now we shall be tied together.
Oh yes, of course. My thanks. Release.
It's a symbolic thing.
It is a symbolic thing, mention that.
This is being done for a reason. There is no blood.
There you go.
Okay, there we go.
You are bound.
You are bound.
Pineapple.
And now the rings, please.
Right. Yep.
Do what it's on.
Give me a finger.
That's fine. I'll adjust.
There you go. The ring, an unbroken circle, represents your unending love. As often as either of you look upon these rings, may you be reminded this moment of the love you have promised to one another.
And cats.
And cats, exactly. Go ahead and you may now kiss each other. Morgan and Kris, I pronounce you bound partners in this life. Thank you for sharing this day with us, and may this bond continue to strengthen the love you already feel for one another. Meredith will now read a final blessing for you both.
May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and rain fall soft upon your fields. May love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. May good and faithful friends be yours, wherever you may roam. May peace and plenty bless your world with joy that long endures. May all of life's passing seasons bring the best to you and yours.
Mm-hmm. That way. Excuse me, Kris, before you leave.
Ha!
Yeah, how about that?
It was such a spicy kiss, I broke your bow tie.
You should kiss again. Okay, ready?
All right, okay, ready? Kiss. Light a flame.
Mm-hmm. I absolutely disagree. Mm-hmm. Can I hear it anyway? Hold on.
I have a cape.
You do have a cape. All right. Well, I guess that is the most of it, but shall we? By Grabthar's hammer. By the sons of Warvan, you shall be henceforth known as wife and husband, husband and wife.
Welcome, everyone. I expect a number of you know that the Queen has decreed there will be no speeches and no toasts. So I expect everyone here understands the grave personal risk to which I am now exposing myself.
He's been disowned.
Having said that, I think I just have to acknowledge that I am unbelievably happy and proud and excited, and I'm glad that you all were with us to witness the union of two people who I think more than almost anyone I've ever met deserve to be with each other and are indeed perfect for each other. And so I want to wish them and all of you a long and fulfilling life. So, to Morgan and Kris.
Wonder. You get your fill to eat, but always finger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
This is a really big day for everybody out here on this dance floor. Can we get a huge round of applause? And Morgan and Kris, for your first dance as a married couple. Thank you. new Mr. and Mrs. Friday night.